That's not bad.
That's what I thought.
Are you keeping the score?
Hmm? Oh, yeah. Well, it's the American Bird Monday, hairdresser on Tuesday. At the moment, I'm working on our very own nurse, Georgie Winton. I've got 3 this week.
I'm talking about scoring on the coit deck.
Hmm? Oh, I don't fancy scoring on the coit deck.
Well, it's about the only thing you don't fancy this morning.
Richard, I'm about to score.
Oh, yes. Oh, that's terrible.
I don't think so. I might just raise my score to 4.
You can't chat her up and the nurse. It's not fair.
They'll never find out.
It's not fair on me. I'm going to chat her up.
Oh, you find your own women. I'm off to the surgery.
Stations, everybody. Attack imminent.
Ladies, tour of the bridge, Captain. Come away in, ladies.
Ah, good morning, ladies. Lovely. Mrs. Tannehaw, very nice to see you.
Hello, Captain. I've got a little complaint to make. Every time I come aboard, you're so busy, it's just as though you're trying to avoid me.
Avoid you, nonsense. It's just that we are rather busier while we sail between the islands.
Excuse me, sir.
You see what I mean? Please excuse me. Yes, Chaffee, what do you want?
Nothing, sir. Just helping you to avoid Mrs. Tranmere.
Ah, thank you. What do we do to keep that other lot happy?
Well, sir, how about the old 3 degrees port? Then a couple of minutes later, you put us back on course with a 3 degrees starboard.
Yes, that'll do. Purser.
Excuse me. Captain.
Port side, Purser.
Of course, sir.
Has Mrs. Tranmere found an officer she fancies yet?
I don't think so, sir.
Oh, dear. 3 degrees starboard, Chief Officer.
3 degrees to starboard it is, sir.
Yeah, what's all this about? I was told we were going to have a game of bridge.
No. You're visiting the bridge. This is the bridge.
Oh, I see. Well, where are the cards?
Ladies, if you'd care to come with me, I will show you the radio room and the officer's wardrobe.
Yes, of course. Come along now, ladies. Careful with the step. Have you enjoyed your trip to the bridge?
No, I thought it was bloody boring.
Oh, can you tell me the way to the bridge?
Oh, yes, of course. Yes. Now, we just go down there. We then turn to the left, and then we go up the stairs, and it's the end of the middle corridor.
Thank you. Bye.
Pleasure. Good morning. But, oh, yes, now, we agreed to rearrange our filing system, didn't we? Something wrong.
Don't speak to me.
Ah, now there is something wrong, isn't there? Now, come on, you can't hide anything from old Duncan.
I told you not to speak to me. Well?
Oh, come, it's a female passenger asked her way, so I told her.
Didn't have to maul her while you were telling her.
Ah, no, see, that's what annoyed you. Now, look, it's quite natural to, when you talk to somebody, to put your arms around them.
Don't touch me.
What? Oh! Sometimes I put my arm around Stuart Clark, and that doesn't mean anything.
Well, if you put your arm around Stuart Clark, and that doesn't mean anything, and you put your arm around that girl, and that doesn't mean anything, what does it mean when you put your arm around me?
Nothing. Oh, no.
I heard you the first time.
Oh, listen, will you?
No.
There's a private fighter. Can I join in? Yeah, well, I think I'll go and do some sunbathing. Anyone care to join me?
Look, here, Stuart. See, he's doing it.
Keep your hands to yourself.
Very joke. Come on, I asked if I could join in. morning, Doctor.
Get stuffed!
Outside, mate, I'm busy.
Doctor,
I'm... Outside!
You can come in, Purser. Dr. Waring and I are finished.
No, we are not.
Yes, we are.
Well, now listen, will you?
Can I do anything, nurse?
Yes, keep your hands to yourself.
You're wanted in the tannery suite.
Oh, ma'am.
But don't worry about your mother. She's in safe hands. The doctor will be along soon.
Oh, I'm not worried. I'm going swimming. Bye.
Hello again.
Pardon?
Hi. Did you find your way to the bridge all right?
Oh, yes.
Doctor, you're...
Purser, just pop in and tell the old cow I'll be along in a minute, will you? Purser, just do it.
Oh, so you're the doctor.
Yep.
My mother's the old cow.
Well, where is he?
He'll be along in a moment, Captain.
So, how about I see you at 7:30 tonight in the discotheque, eh?
Yes, I'd like that.
So would I.
Doctor Waring.
Oh, sorry, sir.
Mrs. Tranmere, this is our senior surgeon, Dr. Waring. I'm sorry about the delay.
Oh, it was worth it.
How do you do? Now, what exactly is wrong, eh?
Well, now, at approximately 1100 hours this evening...
Mr. Purser, I don't think we require your help anymore.
Oh, no.
Well, what happened, Dr. Waring, was this?
Captain, would you mind waiting outside, sir?
Why?
I don't allow spectators when I'm doing an examination.
Oh, right then. I'll be in the officer's mess. Shouldn't you need me? Goodbye.
Bye.
You're very forceful, aren't you? Ordering the captain out.
Well, you have to be sometimes, you know. Anyway, right. Now, twist it on the ankle, you see? Let's have a little look. Oh, it looks fine to me.
It's very nice of you to say so.
Now, do you feel any sensation when I do this?
What woman wouldn't?
Right, well, perhaps you'd like to try standing on it, eh?
I'll try anything once.
Yeah. Well, why don't you just try walking, eh?
Try walking, yes.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. No, just tell me,
I think. Now, don't call me Cecilia.
Now, look here, Cecilia. But no, I won't call you Cecilia. Ooh. Now, look, I am your doctor, and I'm not allowed to... I'm not allowed even to kiss you.
Don't worry.
No, no, please, this is very simple. No, you're much older than me.
You're as young as the people you feel.
Please, please, let's be very sensible about this and just let's sit down and talk about it, eh?
Certainly.
So, so.
Doctor?
About Mrs. Tranmere, sir.
Sit down, Doctor. How's Mrs. Tranmere's ankle?
Oh, well, that's just it, sir. There's nothing wrong with her ankle, sir.
No,
I think I should inform you, sir, that she's made,
Made what?
Improper advances to me, sir.
What?
Yes?
Oh, I'm so pleased.
Pleased?
Mrs. Tranmere is at her happiest when she finds a young officer that she fancies. This time it appears to be you.
I don't fancy her, though.
Ah, that's got nothing to do with it. She's a very important passenger. If you don't chat her up, she won't be happy. And if she's not happy, then I won't be happy. And if I'm not happy, the officers and crew won't be happy. And if they're not happy, you won't be happy.
Yeah, but I'm not happy.
Look, Waring, I'm not asking you to do anything improper.
Yeah, she is, though.
Now, look, I'm holding a little party here this evening. I want you to escort Mrs. Tranmere, dance with her, drink with her. And then, later, you can come to the bridge and watch us arrive at Las Palmas, where Mrs. Tranmere will disembark.
Right. Well, not really, sir. I mean, couldn't you choose somebody else? You know, I mean... You did say she fancied younger officers, sir. I mean, well, Stuart Clark's younger than me.
No, he's not, and you will do it. That's an order.
Oh, but, sir...
An order!
What's up, Doc?
Oh, it's all bad news, mate.
Oh, never mind. I've got some good news for you.
Yeah, I'll tell you the bad news first, right? The captain's just ordered me to escort a randy widow to one of his little parties. But I've already got a date with her daughter.
Oh.
Well, what's the good news, then?
Well, it was good news, so I heard your bad news.
Well, what is it now?
More bad news. Yeah, I've just seen Joyce, and she says she's very sorry about this morning, but the date's still on for tonight.
Oh, no. You're joking.
Well, never mind. Look on the bright side of it. You've got a date with three women tonight.
Yeah.
Oh, excuse me. Good evening, Mrs. Tranmere.
Mean it, Purser.
Doctor, may I have the honor of this dance, Mrs. Tranmere?
No, Purser, you may not.
Ah, good evening, Captain.
Good evening, Purser.
Champagne, sir.
No, thank you. Only one at a time.
Evening, Captain, sir.
Dr. Waring. Good evening, Mrs. Tranmere. Would you care for this dance? Hold that, Purser.
Oh, thank you, Captain.
Would you hold that? Just for a moment, Purser. Oh, you look lovely. Oh. Here I am.
Hello.
Another drink. Whiskey and a gin and tonic, if you please. I'm sorry I'm late, darling.
Well, I'm sorry about this morning.
Oh, that's all right.
Duncan, I'd like to, well, talk about you and me. Mm.
Oh, ah, no, just reminded me, I've got one little job to do. I'll be right back.
Well, hurry up. One whiskey and he's away.
Whiskey and...
Gin
Frizz, eh?
You know, this is the first evening you're on this cruise. I haven't had to go out with my mother.
Your mother? Yeah, oh, look, just remember, I've got to go and see my sister. Won't be a minute, eh?
Okay, I'll still be here.
Hello, Mr. Smithboy. It's a doctor here, yes. If I'm needed, I'm in the dispatch, okay? Right, fine, thank you. Join the cruise?
Oh, yes, I am. What do you do on the ship?
I'm the captain's assistant.
Oh, what rank is that?
Vice captain. Like to dance?
Well, actually, I... Okay.
Just hold on. Ah, strong. There we are.
Oh, Mrs. Thank you very much.
Oh, it's a pleasure, dear lady.
Cheers, Purser. Did you enjoy your dance with Captain?
No, I did not.
Well, his navigation's not too good on the dance floor, eh?
But Duncan, you weren't thinking of asking me to dance yourself, were you?
Oh, no, no, no. I mean, you know, this music really isn't my scene.
Well, why don't we go to the discotheque, huh?
It's too noisy.
Oh. Well, what about going to the Lido bar, then? I believe it's always quiet in the evening.
No, packed solid.
Oh.
So I've been told, anyway.
Oh, would you hold that a minute? How stupid can you get? Do you know what? I think I know what it is you're trying to get at.
Well, Waring, don't just stand there. Go on.
Sir,
that is an order.
Nothing but a trollop. Oh, tell you what, I'll just go to the bar and get us some champagne, eh?
Well, don't be long. I'll be chimming the glasses.
Give me a bottle of champagne, quick.
Oh, there you are.
Hi, you see me.
Where are you going with that?
It was a surprise.
Oh, I'm sorry. You know,
something I've just bought for later, you know?
Duncan, I'm bored with this bar. I know, let's go to the discotheque.
Oh, no, you wouldn't like it there. You know, it's all those hot, sweaty bodies and noisy. It's very unhealthy. No, let's just stay here, the two of us, alone.
All right, we'll just stay here and talk.
Right.
Wow.
Just gonna chill it. Won't be long, darling.
doctor to come to the Tenerife suite immediately. Yes, it is urgent. Thank you.
Hello, doctor. Yes, the Tenerife suite. Yes, all right. Captain, he wants me to do a spot of driving.
Oh.
Yes, he likes me to take the corners sometimes. I won't be long. Will you be here when I get back?
Probably.
Oh, good, good.
Jimmy, what are you doing with her?
Chatting her up.
Crying with her.
Well, I hadn't noticed. Oh, is she one of the trio?
Yeah.
Oh, well, let me know if there's anything you can't handle, though.
Yeah. Oh, champagne.
Oh, yeah, lots of. Later. Well, you weren't supposed to have seen it.
Why not?
Well, I was saving it for later on, eh?
Young, you seem a little tired. Why don't we go to the Lido bar? It's usually quiet
and No. I like it here.
It's a pity you're not here more often.
Yes. Oh, look, just reminds me. I've got to go to the bar to get the drinks because there's no waiters. Be back in a minute. What do you want?
Gonna bring a record.
Come in.
Oh, good evening.
You're not Dr. Waring.
No, he's not on duty at nights. I'm Dr. Stuart Clark.
Never mind. You'll do.
Now then, what seems to be the trouble?
Well, have this sort of
another drink.
I want to go to the discotheque. Well,
have another drink first, eh?
No, I'm fed up with sitting here. Come on.
Sorry, let's go start it off, eh? In you go.
Just me 1 minute, right?
Right.
And then we go to the discotheque.
Right.
Right.
Jimmy. Let's go to the Lido, Marcella. For a quick yeah. Why don't we go and have a dance, eh?
But I thought you liked it here.
No, you much prefer it.
Excuse me. Oh, you're a wild dancer.
Well, I've been thrashing around all day.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Captain Loftus. We'll shortly be arriving in Los Palmas. Please go.
Now look here, Mrs. Thing. I'm a doctor, and you're a patient, and we've got to be very...
Now you listen to me, Dr. Stuart, whatever your highfalutin name is. Your British upper lip's so stiff, I'm surprised it doesn't crack. And if you see Dr. Waring, tell him I've gone to the bridge.
Can you tell Dr. Waring that I've gone to the bridge if he ever comes out of there?
Hello, Joyce.
Hello.
And Joyce, have you seen a girl in a white dress with red hair and sort of,
No. Have you seen a doctor in a white jacket, dark hair and sort of...
I'll tell you what. Let's go up on the deck and see the ship coming into Las Palmas.
Yeah. Hey, why not ask the captain if we can go up on the bridge to watch it?
Oh, I'd rather go up on the deck.
No, because it's your first trip and I've never seen it. He won't mind.
But I'd rather go up on the
deck. 1 degree starboard.
1 degree starboard it is, sir.
Come in. Who's there?
It's Dr. Waring, sir. Is Mr. Tranmere here?
She certainly is. Where the hell did you get to?
I want a word with you.
Well, you'd better make it fast. He's likely to disappear in a minute.
Dr. Waring, I ordered you, asked you to escort Mrs. Tranmere here this evening. You disobeyed that order, request. You will leave this bridge at once.
Oh, yes, sir. Thank you.
Waring's a fine doctor, but as an officer, he's a long way to go.
A long way to go? He didn't even get as far as my suite this evening.
Half a head.
Is that what his problem is? By the way, did I hear you say you ordered him to escort me tonight?
Steady as you go.
Steady as you go it is, sir.
Come in.
Come in it is, sir.
Good evening, Miss Tranmere.
Good evening, Captain. I was just wondering if Dr. Waring was here.
No, he just left.
It seems to be a habit of his.
How would you know?
Come in.
It's Stuart Clark and Nurse Winton, sir. Permission to come on the bridge?
Yes, if you're quiet.
I beg your pardon, sir?
I said yes, if you're quiet.
Is Dr. Waring here?
Steady as you go.
No.
What do you mean, no?
I'm sorry. Steady as you go, it is, sir. Nurse Winton was asking if Dr. Waring was here.
Well, he ruddy well isn't.
But I was supposed to meet Dr. Waring here.
What do you mean you were supposed to meet him here?
I was supposed to meet Dr. Waring, but not here.
Fisher, German, biting ruddy rock off.
Once and for all, Dr. Waring is not here. Waring?
Turn that light on.
Oh, yes, sir.
Now, listen to me, Duncan Waring.
What's the big idea of leaving me hanging around the leader?
No, I was going to come back.
You were dating my daughter when you were supposed to be with me.
Supposed to be with you? You were supposed to be with me.
I can explain.
Well, go on, then.
Turn that bloody light out.
Oh, wait a minute. Who are you?
I'm his girlfriend.
I was his girlfriend.
Yes, that's Nurse Winton. Very nice, she's too.
No, Joyce, I cannot.
Don't touch me!
Oh, yes, thank you.
For God's sake, Waring, I'm trying to bring a 15,000 ton liner into Las Palmas. And all I get are competitive accounts of your ruddy sex life. You're supposed to be an officer, not a ruddy prize bull. I do not want to hear anything more about you and another woman for the rest of this voyage. Now get off my bridge! Well, nobody put this ruddy light out.
Excuse me, Captain.
Women. Nothing but trouble. Never touch them again as long as I live.
Good evening, Maggie.
Hello, Duncan.
Fine,
thanks.
Hey, look, do you fancy going on shore for a couple of drinks at the club?
Oh, yes, I'd love to.
Great. Hey, look, I'm very sorry about this morning. Oh,